Torrey Pines. Just an exhibition match, nothing counting for the online tour. This is just for fun. Only for the reason that I've never actually played this golf course online or in real life, so I figured today was a great opportunity with a slow start to the day to find myself around this golf course. So that wasn't a great start, a big slicey swing, and not the side of the golf course we want to be on for the pin location. So typically I'd hit an 8-iron here, but I'm going to opt to try to hit a fadey slicey shot into that back right corner, see if we can get one chased into that flag. To aim there and see if we can hang one out there. Not an easy shot. We got a bit of a gap to chase through, but get down. That was a good shot. Shot shape there, right on line. Beautiful fade. We just a little too much club. Just a touch, otherwise it was right over top of that flag. It was a great little shot. About 30 feet to the flag. Just on the frame, so I'm gonna see if we can get lucky and chip one in. No, not even scaring the hole. So just to change it up a little bit, just because this is one of my favorite courses to watch online, I figured I'd turn the auto flybys on. Just to make myself a little more familiar with the golf course. Again, I watch it on TV, but I'm still not that familiar with the course itself. So I aim at that left side fairway bunker, try to peel one off of it. Shot. Left us with about 82 yards. These pin locations aren't the easiest. This one's all the way in the back. Trying to figure out what 82 yards is here. Good distance there. Tricky little par three coming up. Yeah, I never paid attention to what the pin locations were set up at, meaning if they were set up hard, medium, easy. Well, they're definitely not easy, I know that much. So, 32 feet down, we're probably playing about 147. See if we can get a fade tucked into that right-hand corner, a little closer to the flag here. little too much club. I got a 9-iron here. It's a little too much club for me, but nice smooth swing. Knock a little distance off if we can actually get a nice fade hit here. That was a hollow rocket. Shoot. That sucks, man. Wow. That just changed things, didn't it? That mess up. Every now and then a hosel rocket haunts us, and that was exactly what happened on that shot. I was really trying to cut the ball with a 9-iron and knock some distance off, and I stuck my arms out a little bit, and I'm sure everybody's familiar with that shot. Thankfully, I was able to recover from it, as ugly as it was. That little approach 70-yard shot that I hit tucked up on that last shot there was a gap wedge. So I've been working on using the gap wedge for those lower trajectory type of shots and kind of got the distance dialed in quite good on the range. About 65 to 70 yards in that area for gap wedge, half, three-quarter swing. And that one paid off really well there. Oh, not cutting. Yeah. So expecting the stock standard fade there. .172. .172 8-iron, 14 feet uphill. Yeah, I'm gonna try it anyway. It might not be enough club with the little uphill distance, but. Just barely got a bounce on there. Hit it a little thin. Pushed it, got it a little low on the blade. Two-foot putt here. Should find the hole. So for E6 putting, anything around that 20-foot mark, just from practicing actually on one of the E6, I'll call it the putting greens, the practice area. You do a lot of 20-foot putts for practice and got a really good understanding of that feel. And it makes things a heck of a lot easier. So this one, again, stock standard fade, and trying to get something going on. The driver so far isn't cooperating. Should be alright. Typically, I would have aimed down the left side of the fairway in my normal shot shape, but just got lazy and left the aim line down the middle and missed the fairway by whatever that is, 5 yards. .105. I'm going to use my lob wedge. It's not a lob wedge option in the club select there, so. I'll leave it on sand wedge, but I'm going to hit my lob wedge at a 58 degrees, so I think a full shot with this club is about 104. So somewhere over top of that flag would be ideal. Maybe get a little spin back. That one a little thin, so it's gonna fly far. Yeah, I deserved that. That was a low-bladed ball. That was definitely a mistake. All I had to do is put the club on the ball there and probably would have, for that distance, got a gimme out of it. Sure, 18 inches downhill. Probably about a 40, 45 foot putt. Take the gimme, 5 feet, it's pretty much a guaranteed in the cup all the time, so gimme set to 10 right now. Nice looking hole, dog leg right. Probably aim for that center bunker and let it leak back to the middle of the fairway. That would be the ideal shot. Cut a bit. Easy shot. Again, to get all that reach, I would like to carry this about 245, so we can definitely reach 3-iron, hybrid, we can definitely reach, but that flag in the back right corner is not an easy flag. So definitely got to hit a bit of a cut shot. I would like to hit my hybrid, but I don't think that much fade. I'm not sure we're going to get there, so I'm going to opt to hit my 3-wood. I'm going to really put a slice on it to see if we can curl it into that back corner. I don't need to hit it as hard as I think I need to, I guess. I don't want to fly the green, but... Oh, that was a bad shot. I'd like to have that one again because we're short-sighted and that sucks. Darn it, that was a bad shot. I would have been able to do 50% better than that with my 3-iron. Anyway, we got a 50-footer, short-sided. Stop. Line looks okay. left fairway bunker again. Come on. Get on the fairway. So my driving accuracy is not that great, but there's a majority of the time I'm missing the fairway by just a few yards. A yard here, a yard there. This one we got probably a smooth 9-iron here. 9-iron might be a little bit too much club. We're just outside the range of a pitching wedge, so a smooth 9-iron and see how we do. Benefit when you're in the golf course, or specifically online here at E6 Connect, one club longer, I don't get a lot of spin, and that's the goal here, as we're all aware. But spin kicks my butt in this simulator software, so. Typically on a shot like that, a full pitching wedge, if I would have tried to muscle it there, I would have spun away and probably missed our gimme. This one's at the back of the green, back center, playing about 176, 7-iron. Be too far. Holy. Huh. Yeah, I don't carry a 7-iron 184, but I even tried to swing smooth on that one. So close to the back edge, not a lot of green to work with there. That 7-iron surprised me on how far that actually went. I did not expect that. Take the par and move on. Yeah, it was right at the flag. It's just hit way too far. Off of that left fairway bunker, and we should be okay there. Similar distance, almost the exact same yardage that we had on the last par 5 that I chose a 3-wood to try to get that back right corner, but I don't need a 3-wood this time. Oh, I pushed that one bad. I was trying to hit a touch of draw on it, and I left just, I can feel on the backswing there, open the club face up. No way that was going to get squared up on impact. actually quite a easy birdie of a hole, this one. Well, we got the birdie, had to work hard for it, but we got it. I'm not a huge fan of trying to hit a draw with a driver. I can, not in a high percentage, but this hole I need to be on the left side of the fairway, and I don't want to aim so far over top of the cart path to play the normal fade that it is set up for a bit of a draw, so we're gonna hit a draw. Or we're gonna hit a slice. Trying to hit a draw. Now we're really in trouble. Shoot. That wasn't very good. Alright. That was a botched shot, that one. Reason why we shouldn't be able to pop this one in the hole. Lipped out. Probably a little too much weight. It's a 12 footer in the side with a chip is tough to judge. It's a tough one to judge for sure. Decent par three. Far enough to make you think about it. Playing 205, tucked way back in the corner. 205, I'm gonna hit a 5-iron. 5-iron fade and try to get at that flag. I just hope it's not too much club. Cut. That's not cutting enough. Jeez. That distance is way off. I've airmailed that green with a 5-iron. Obviously the distances on this particular course I'm playing here are off. So that's got some challenges to it. Well, we might have our first really big mistake. Saved after all that messy stuff. Well, Definitely the par threes. That's two of them now that I've just had very, very bad yardage on. The club and the yardage was okay, but for whatever reason, they're flying far. So now I'm struggling with what yardage to hit, what club to hit on those par threes anyway. Oh, shoot. That is no good. Oh, man. I don't know how bad these trees are going to affect anything, but I'm just going to hit a, gap wedge out. If I knew these trees weren't going to cause me any grief, I would try to go at the flag. I just don't know. I don't know if that's the case. Well, the trees definitely caused some trouble, so I ricocheted off to the left. We gotta get an up and down now. Tuck this one in really close for this next shot here. Four-footer here, downhill. Come on. Yeah, and see, based on my marker here on the floor, I got a piece of tape on the floor here. Help me, give me an aim reference point. And I was right on the right side of that the whole way. So, well-deserved bogey that one was. Play the fade and muscle one down there straight, or at least touch a draw. Oh no! I don't even think I hit a groove on that driver there. It was like way below the grooves even. Now we got some distance out of us. Taking the conventional fairway approach on this one, but try to get up and down on a 50-yard shot here, and life will be good. Or a 60-yard shot and have to putt like hell. Thank you. play the whole damn way down the fairway. So all in all, a pretty good course. I like the layout, obviously. You're very familiar. Everyone's familiar with Torrey Pines, but a lot of dogleg rights, a lot of the kind of equal amount of dogleg lefts, which makes you play the golf course. And I am having trouble getting the ball to move right to left with my driver. And that's not completely unusual. Just can't get it to go left. It'll be all right, but swinging for jaws and leaving the face wide open. Come on. That was a really good putt. Really, really good putt. That one should have dropped. Like 0 for 4 on drawing the ball with the driver, so we're going to give up on that. Back to Old Faithful here. Hard. Wow, that went farther than I thought I was going to go. Too hard. Yeah, I just hit that too hard. It was perfect line. Just hit the edge of the hole and too much pace. Seems like, I guess not all of them. A lot of the par threes have been tucked back right. And the last yardage I hit was about this distance, 205. I opted for a 5-iron and turned out very poorly. So now what? 5-iron flew the coop. Try to hit a 6-iron here. There's definitely a discrepancy in the carry distance on this particular course. Sea level is sea level. It's zero pretty much, right on the ocean. A Well, I'll try to cut it in and see how we go here. It's a good line if we got the right club. Well, we have the right club. Nice little cut shot to the pin. I'd like to see that one go in. Standard routine, aim down the left and land in the center. Or in this case, the right bunker. Yeah, that didn't turn over. We'll call that a slice, not a fade. Well, as promised, I forgot to keep changing my club in the top left corner of the screen. Haven't done that for a few holes now. Anyway, we're gonna try a 9-iron, smooth little 9-iron. Try not to fly the green. Pulled it a bit. Flew the green. My problem when I try to take some off of a club, I'll swing with my upper body, not get a good rotation on my hips, and then I'll just swing all arms, kind of do an over the hop top pull hook. That's exactly what that was. Go in. Hit the hole and bounced over top. That would have been nice. One lonely pond on this golf course. This one a little extra to get a club that's kind of a mid short iron in would be nice. Shot 271. Yeah, that was swung hard, hit it off the heel, big old slicey one. Could have hit just a 7-iron, get it back into play. And try to get up and down for bird. So 79 yards, gonna hit a gap wedge. Hopefully we get a little bounce forward, skip to the hole. We get our yardage right here. Here we go. bad round. 66, first time playing, was a little bit ugly, but if you guys stayed in there, hung in there for the whole 18 holes, I really appreciate you watching. If you liked the video, please click the thumbs up. And if you haven't subscribed already, please do. Really appreciate it. We'll catch you next time.